Hello, Philip. I am surprised to see you on my Zoom screen. Why are you peeking in on my show today?
Hello, Brooke. I always look forward to the opportunity of seeing you in the flesh, even if you are thousands of miles away. But I noticed that a few of your selections for today's podcast were a bit unusual.
The theme that you presented to me was very challenging. I had an extremely difficult time finding singers to accomplish your intent. Maybe you should create your own playlist, as you typically do.
That will not be necessary. I taught you well. I am quite happy with your selections, even if they stray from the popular music field. Haven't I always said that we showcase all genres of music? Your song selections are a welcome departure from those hackneyed oldies that everyone else plays.
Okay, then. It was nice to see you, Philip, but you can leave now. You always make me a bit nervous. I got this.
Okay, Brooke, have a good show.
Philip was not wrong. This first song proves the point. This woman sang on Broadway, but few people would consider her a great singer. Her name is Bea Arthur. And you might be interested to learn that Bea Arthur was a woman Marine during World War II. Some of you may not even remember Bea Arthur. She really came to fame as the character Maud on the sitcom All in the Family. She was so popular, she had her own primetime Emmy-winning spin-off show on CBS that lasted 7 seasons until 1978. She also won the 1966 Tony Award for Best Featured Actress in a Musical for playing Vera Charles in MAME. Our first song is from Gypsy, a Broadway musical with music by Jules Stein, lyrics by Stephen Sondheim, and a book by Arthur Laurent. It is loosely based on the 1957 memoirs of striptease artist Gypsy Rose Lee and focuses on her mother, Rose, whose name has become synonymous with the ultimate show business mother. Here is Bea Arthur, as Rose, singing Some People. This is from a live album performed by Miss Arthur. It's entitled Bea Arthur on Broadway, Just Between Friends, released in 2001.
Some people can get a thrill knitting sweaters and sitting still. That's okay for some people who don't know they're alive. Some people can thrive and bloom living life in a living room. That's perfect for some people of 105. But I at least gotta try. When I think of all the sights that I gotta see at, all the places I gotta play, all the things that I gotta be at, come on, Papa, what do you say? Some people can be content playing bingo and paying rent. That's peachy for some people, for some humdrum people to be. But some people ain't me. Oh God, you know, all my life I have wanted to play that part. Mama Rose. Ever since I saw the first run through, without sets, without costumes, without lighting, the first run through of what has been unanimously called the perfect musical, Gypsy. I had a dream, a wonderful dream, Papa. All about June and the Orpheum Circuit. Give me a chance, I know I can work it. Oh, what a dream. Just as real as can be, Papa. There I was in Mr. Orpheum's office, and he was saying to me, Rose, get yourself some new orchestrations, new routines and red velvet curtains. Get a feathered hat for the baby, photographs in front of the theater. Get an agent and in jig time, you'll be being booked in the big time. Oh, what a dream. A wonderful dream, Papa. And all that I need is $88, Papa. That's what he said, Papa. Only $88, Papa.
You ain't getting 88 cents from me, Rose.
Then I'll get it someplace else. and I'll get it, and I'll get my kids out. Goodbye to blueberry pie. Good riddance to all the socials I had to go to, all the lodges I had to play, all the Shriners I said hello to. Hey, L.A., I'm coming your way. Some people sit on their butts. Got the dream, yeah, but not the guts. That's living for some people, for some humdrum people, I suppose. Well, they can stay and rot. But not Rose.
From Broadway, we move to a gospel rendition of a melody from the Great American Songbook. Without a Song was composed by Vincent Yeomans, with lyrics later added by Billy Rose and Edward Eliscu. It was published in 1929. This was included in the musical play, Great Day. The play only ran for 36 performances, but contained this terrific composition that has been covered over 250 times. This next song is by Reverend James Cleveland, known as the King of Gospel. He was an American gospel singer, musician, and composer. Reverend Cleveland was a driving force behind the creation of the modern gospel sound by incorporating traditional black gospel, soul, and pop and jazz in arrangements for mass choirs. Throughout his career, he appeared on hundreds of recordings and earned 4 Grammy Awards. He was the first gospel musician to earn a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. He was inducted into the Gospel Music Hall of Fame in 1984. This next song made Billboard's Bubbling Under Hot 100 chart in 1966.
Song. trouble and woe. Sure as I know the Jordan, will roll. But I'll get along as long as the sun is down in my soul. I'll never know what makes the grass grow tall. I'll never know what makes the rain to fall. Unless God gives you a song, I only know.
Our third song is from a man who needs no introduction. This is former Beatle, George Harrison, singing his second number one hit as a solo artist. It's from 1973, called Give Me Love, Give Me Peace on Earth. To that I say, Amen.
Life, keep me free, touch will reach you with heart and soul. Give me love, give me love, give me peace on earth. Give me light, give me life, keep me free from birth. Now give me hope and help me cope with this heavy load.
Unless you listen to quite a bit of bluegrass, you probably do not know the music of Michael Cleveland. He is a bluegrass fiddler. Mr. Cleveland won the 2015 International Bluegrass Music Award for Fiddle Player of the Year. In 2018, Michael Cleveland was nominated for a Grammy for Best Bluegrass Album for his solo album entitled Fiddler's Dream. And 2 years later, he won that Grammy Award for Best Bluegrass Album. It was entitled Tall Fiddler. This next song is Tennessee Plates, from that album. Do you remember hearing this in the movie Thelma and Louise, performed by Charlie Sexton?
I woke up in a hotel, didn't know what to do. Turned the TV on and wrote a letter to you. The news was talking about a dragnet upon the interstate. Seems they were looking for a Cadillac with Tennessee plates. Since I left California, baby, things have gotten worse. The land of opportunity for me is just a curse. Tell the judge in Bakersfield my trial will have to wait. Down here they're looking for a Cadillac with Tennessee plates. It was somewhere in Nevada, it was cold outside. She was shivering in the dark, so I offered her a ride. Three bank jobs later, four cars hot wired. We crossed the Mississippi like an old slick fire. Up to they wouldn't have let us in when we landed in Memphis like original sin. Elvis Presley Boulevard to the Graceland gates. See, we were looking for a Cadillac with Tennessee plates. Well, there must have been a dozen of them parked in that garage. There wasn't one Lincoln and there wasn't one Dodge. There wasn't one Japanese. Cadillac with Tennessee plates. She saw him singing once when she was 17. Ever since that day she'd been a living in between. I was never king of nothing but this wild weekend. Anyway he wouldn't care, hell he gave him to his friends. Up at Brushy Mountain, where yours sincerely's doing 5 to 8. Just a spending out my time making Tennessee plates.
We'll let you know what all these singers have in common after this next song. It is an antique oldie from 1948, just like Philip. This song spent 16 weeks on Billboard's pop chart that year, and it peaked at number 13. We are featuring the original release of this song. In 1948, we are still at the cusp of the big band era. This is Ray McKinley and Some of the Boys. Ray McKinley is singing.
You came a long way from St. Louis. You climbed the ladder of success. I've seen the town and country cars that were parked out in front of your fancy address. You came a long way from St. Louis. You broke a lot of hearts between. I've seen a gang of gloomy guys who were doing all right till you came on the scene. You came here from the Middle West and certainly impressed the population hereabouts. But baby, I've got news for you. I'm from Missouri too, so naturally I got my doubts. You've got them dropping by the wayside, a feeling I ain't gonna know. You came a long way from St. Louis, but baby, you still got a long way to go. From the Middle West and certainly impressed the population hereabouts. But baby, I've got news for you. I'm from Missouri too, so naturally I got my doubts. You got them dropping by the wayside, a feeling I ain't gonna know. You came a long way from St. Louis, but baby, you still got a long way to go. You haven't fooled me, you know. Still got a long way to go.
We have lots of knowledgeable listeners of the Music Mall. I'm thinking most of you knew that these singers all shared their last name with a United States president, beginning with the 21st, Chester Alan Arthur, followed by Grover Cleveland, Benjamin Harrison, and then Grover Cleveland again. Did you know Grover Cleveland is the only president to serve two non-consecutive terms as president? Might that happen again in 2024? It is possible. And finally, the 25th president was William McKinley. He was also the third U.S. president who was assassinated. That happened in 1901. Theodore Roosevelt succeeded President McKinley to become the 22nd president. It is not easy to find a singer or band named Roosevelt, unless you include the first name Roosevelt. But we will feature a German singer who performs under the name Roosevelt. He has released three recent albums. His first one, entitled Roosevelt, peaked at number 11 on Billboard's top US dance and electronic albums chart. But this next video is from his second album, Young Romance. It's called Shadows. Our younger audience may like this. We, at the mall, did.
Thank you.
William Howard Taft was Teddy Roosevelt's chosen successor to become the next president. And in 1908, he won his election comfortably over William Jennings Bryan. But in 1912, he lost his next election when Teddy Roosevelt, unhappy with President Taft's leadership and wanting himself to be back in charge of the country, ran against him as a third-party candidate. President Roosevelt ran on the Bull Moose Party ticket. This split the Republican Party votes, giving the win to Democratic candidate Woodrow Wilson. In 1921, William Howard Taft would become the first and only ex-president to become a Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. We salute President Taft with a song by blues rock musician Dudley Taft. Next is a cover of Willie Mabon's classic non-Hot 100 song from 1955. It's called Seventh Son. You can find this track on Dudley Taft's self-released album from 2010. The album is called Left for Dead. It's now 1913, and Woodrow Wilson takes his oath of office on March 4. He was a Virginian who became the president of Princeton University and later governor of New Jersey. He appealed to many Southerners, having been one of them. Having benefited from President Taft and Theodore Roosevelt splitting the Republican ticket, Woodrow Wilson won 435 out of 531 electoral votes. And this was with 42% of the popular vote. President Wilson argued against entering World War I, which began in 1914, but in 1917, after a series of attacks on American commercial ships, President Wilson asked Congress for a declaration of war, and the United States was now in it. To represent Mr. Wilson, we present Jackie Wilson's highest charted pop hit. This is Night, from 1960. This song even did better than his popular recordings of Lonely Teardrops, and Your Love Keeps Lifting Me Higher and Higher. This song is based on the aria, Mon Coeur S'ouvre à Ta Voix, from the opera, Samson and Delilah, by Camille Saint-Saëns. Lyrics are by Johnny Lerman.
Another night to dream about you. Night, each lovely night, the only time I'm not without. Once more, I feel your kisses. Once more, I know what bliss is. Comes done, my darling, you're gone, but you come back into my arms each kisses. Once more, I know what bliss is. Comes dawn, my darling, you're gone, but you come back into my arms.
We are headed into the Roaring Twenties. 100 years ago today, the President of the United States was Warren G. Harding. President Harding was a member of the Republican Party and one of the most popular sitting U.S. presidents. However, after his death, a number of scandals were exposed, including Teapot Dome, as well as an extramarital affair with Nan Britton, which diminished his reputation. He died in office during his first term, in August 1923. And we feature Karen Harding, from Consett, a town in the northeast region of England. This next song is entitled, Say Something. Say Something was her debut single. It was released in the United Kingdom as a digital download on February 1, 2015, through Method Records. The song was written by Karen Harding and Uzoechi Emenike, who also produced the song. This song peaked at number 7 on the UK singles chart. However, this song never entered Billboard's Hot 100.
Lately you've been quiet, is there something on your mind, baby? senses killing me so much that it's driving me crazy. The three words in your head drift ahead like they're gonna come save me. Oh, lately you've been quiet. Is there something on your mind, baby, baby,
baby?
Upon the death of Warren G. Harding, his vice president, Calvin Coolidge, born in Vermont, and former governor of Massachusetts, becomes the 30th president of the United States. Mr. Coolidge gains almost universal praise for his stalwart support of racial equality during a period of heightened racial tension in the United States, and is highly praised by advocates of smaller government and laissez-faire economics. Supporters of an active central government generally view him far less favorably. His critics argue that he failed to use the country's economic boom to help struggling farmers and workers in other flailing industries. As his presidency ends, the Great Depression is looming only months away. And who else but Rita Coolidge would serve as our fitting tribute for Silent Cal, as he was called? This is her number two pop hit from 1977, Your Love Has Lifted Me Higher and Higher.
Your love is lifting me higher than I've ever been lifted before. Than I've ever been lifted before. I can stand up and face the world again. Your love is lifting me higher than I've ever lived it before. So keep it up, quench my desire, and I'll be at your side forevermore. Know your love is lifting me higher than I've ever lifted before. So keep it up, quench my
From the time of Warren G. Harding in 1921, Republicans had controlled the White House during the Roaring Twenties. It was a time of a surging economy which created an era of mass consumerism, as jazz-age flappers flouted prohibition laws, and the Harlem Renaissance redefined arts and culture. Hollywood would become a great cultural influence, as talking pictures took over the celluloid world of entertainment. But then it all came falling down. In 1929, the stock market crashes. Add to this, the collapse of world trade, due to the Smoot-Hawley tariff, ineffective government policies, bank failures and panics leading to the collapse of the money supply. And this all equals the Great Depression. Herbert Hoover becomes the 31st president on March 4, 1929, about 6 months before the economic collapse. Although his predecessor's policies undoubtedly contributed to this crisis, which lasted over a decade, President Hoover bore much of the blame in the minds of the American people. He was, in fact, a brilliant man. He was a member of the inaugural, pioneer class, of Stanford University, entering in 1891. He became a mining engineer, amassing great wealth. He had an estimated personal fortune of $4 million, equivalent to over $108 million in 2021. And during World War II, he was a great humanitarian, helping to feed the war-torn people of Europe. And we feature Brittany Hoover to represent this president. She is a country singer from Oklahoma. In 2007, she had the first release of Country Strong. 3 years later, Gwyneth Paltrow would perform this song in the movie of the same name. Here is Brittany Hoover's original version of the song, Country Strong.
White-eyed dreamer who just rolled in on a dusty Midwest bus. Yeah, on the outside I look fragile, but on the inside it's something you can't crush. I'm country strong, hard to break.
With the country in dire straits from the Depression, still reeling after 3 years, the voters turned to Democrat Franklin Delano Roosevelt of New York. He was a great admirer of his distant cousin, Republican Theodore Roosevelt. In 1905, FDR married Eleanor Roosevelt, the niece of Theodore Roosevelt. Several men have become president having overcome learning disabilities. But FDR's physical disability, due to polio, was a handicap he rarely mentioned and tried to hide from the public. FDR's accomplishments are many. He used the power of the federal government to put people back to work. With the support of a Democratic Congress, he passed Social Security benefits for older Americans and unemployment insurance, the GI Bill, and a myriad of programs to help Americans in need. It was World War II that prompted FDR to seek an unprecedented third and fourth term. He oversaw the development of the atomic bomb, but died in office before the actual end of World War II. Not everyone supported FDR's expanded role of the federal government. And the debate continues today. However, in a 2021 survey of the greatest American presidents, Franklin Roosevelt placed third, behind Abraham Lincoln and George Washington. We conclude this podcast with a spoken recording. This actual speech was recorded on two sides of a shellac disc. We present only side one of this record, due to its length of more than 7 minutes. The entire recording is available on YouTube. This is Franklin Delano Roosevelt representing himself. The video is archival. The recording presented here is from side one of Columbia Records, number 36516.
Mr. Vice President, Mr. Speaker, members of the Senate, of the House of Representatives, yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The United States was at peace with that nation, and at the solicitation of Japan, was still in conversation with its government and its emperor, looking toward the maintenance of peace in the Pacific. Indeed, 1 hour after Japanese air squadrons had commenced bombing in the American island of Oahu, the Japanese ambassador to the United States and his colleague delivered to our Secretary of State a formal reply to a recent American message.
And while this reply stated that it seemed useless to continue the existing diplomatic negotiation, it contained no threat or hint of war or of armed attack.
It will be recorded that the distance of Hawaii from Japan makes it obvious that the attack was deliberately planned many days or even weeks ago. During the intervening time, the Japanese government has deliberately sought to deceive the United States by false statements and expressions of hope for continued peace.
The attack yesterday on the Hawaiian Islands has caused severe damage to American naval and military forces. I regret to tell you that very many American lives have been lost. In addition, American ships have been reported torpedoed on the high seas between San Francisco and Honolulu.
Yesterday, the Japanese government also launched an attack against Malaya. Last night, Japanese forces attacked Hong Kong. Last night, Japanese forces attacked Guam. Last night, Japanese forces attacked the Philippine Islands. Last night, the Japanese attacked Wake Island. And this morning, the Japanese attacked Midway Island.